Hello friends and welcome to my channel. My name is Deepshikha Bhoumik and in the previous video we had spoken about succession planning and how do we select successors and what are the parameters of selecting, what are the process, what are the some of the evaluation methods. I'm sharing with you the link of the video here. And in today's video we are going to talk about balanced scorecard. What is balanced scorecard and how are we going to use it in business? What is the relevance of balanced scorecard in performance management system? What are the perspectives of balanced scorecard and how are they relevant to our businesses? We will learn from my experiences of implementing the balanced scorecard. And if you have any questions, please write to me at dwpshii@gmail.com. That's my email address. We are going to make a series of videos on each of these perspectives of balanced scorecard, and if you want to implement the balanced scorecard in your organization, please get in touch. So the balanced scorecard is nothing but a strategic management tool which the organizations use in order to align the strategy of the organization to the day-to-day tasks and activities of an individual and trying to tell each individual what are the tasks that they should be prioritizing on to streamline the internal business functions in order to get the external desired results. Now, when I say business results, it does not always mean financial results or financial outcomes. It also has various other things which are related to the financial outcomes and are operational in nature. So, to give you an example, say we are in the business development department. Now, in order to bring in new businesses, business development enters into, let's say, some new segments or sunrise sectors as they call it. Now, in order to bring in business, you have to put tenders into all these sunrise sectors. When you are tendering, there is a lot of money that gets involved. There is earnest money deposit and there are security deposits. Especially in cases where the bids are unsuccessful, all this money that gets stuck on is also something that impacts your day-to-day functioning. Now, the number of successful bids to unsuccessful bids and the earnest money that has gone into these unsuccessful bids are also something that needs to be measured. When you are bringing in business, you have to not only see that what is the kind of business that you are bringing in, what is the quantum of business that you are bringing in, but also the fact that these businesses need to be brought in, these order bookings need to be done on a phase-wise manner so that there is less of order backlog to the organization. Again, when you are going into a new business, you also need to understand the various other factors like the turnaround time, payment cycle, customer satisfaction, collection cycle, are all these factors that contribute to the sustainability of organizations which will otherwise not be surfacing when you are only taking in the financial measures. And that is where the success of the balanced scorecard lies. So what the scorecard does is it breaks down the deliverables into these buckets of business, customer, internal process and learning and growth. And we are going to talk about each one of these in the next coming up video. The mentor who taught me the entire concept actually taught me upside down. So what I was told is it is always a learning and growth perspective which should be at the top. And we will start our discussion with learning and growth perspective. So stay tuned and we'll meet you in the next video. Thank you.